In this section, we'll discuss about the jump statement. So while coding, there occurs many scenarios where we want to alter the flow of loops, and jump statements come in handy in such situation. So in this section, we are going to discuss about two type of jump statements, break and continue. There is another type of jump statement, go to, but we are not going to cover it in our section because we rarely use it and it is generally advisable to not use go to. So if you are interested, you can go and read about it yourself, but in our course we are going to cover break and continue. So break is basically used to terminate the loop or switch case, like a case within a switch statement. So just ignore the switch and case thing, just focus on the loop part. So it is used when we want to terminate the loop. So our in the last section we have seen that the loop terminates when the test condition of a loop is evaluates to false. So break is just another way to terminate it even though the test condition is not evaluating to false. And when break gets evaluated, the control passes to the first statement of the loop. So the first statement after the loop actually. So let's see with an example. So I have written a while statement. Assume that these are the statements, like let's say statement one or statement two. So if like generally how the execution goes is the while statement get executed, the condition is checked, statement one get executed, two gets executed. And in case the break statement gets executed, what will happen is the loop will get terminated and the control will pass to this statement, let's say statement X. So instead of the loop going in the repeated manner or in the cyclic flow, the loop gets terminated on encountering break and the control flows to the first statement after the loop body. Next, let's see continue statement. So continue statement takes the control to the beginning of loop. It differs from break statement in a way that instead of terminating the loop, it just skips the statement that are written after it. So for example, here we have taken an example of a for loop where the loop variable I, loop counter I, iterates from 5 to 100. Now in this situation, we have statement, let's say 1, statement 2, statement 3 and statement 4. Now these statements, statement 1 and 2 will get executed for each iteration. But as soon as this continue is encountered, the control will flow to the for statement. So the first statement, that is the beginning of the loop, which is the loop body, the loop statement. In case of for, it's a for statement. In case of while, it can be the while statement. So it the control passes to the beginning of loop and these two statements gets skipped. So you must be wondering, like, then if in each and every scenario these statements are getting skipped, then why we are writing these statements? So generally continue and break are written within a if condition. Only when a specific condition evaluates to true, we break or continue the loop. Else the normal flow of loop continue to persist. That's all for this video. In the next section, we'll see how it works. We'll write some sample codes and see how continue and break works.